Hello, everybody. It's me, Understar Virgo, here with Monster Hunter Rise Sunbreak. Most likely the last time I will actually be streaming any of it for quite a while, because, well, I'm in the point of endgame where it's like, oh, here, raise your hunter rank 60 levels then for this one new monster to unlock. And that's just not really fun to for people to watch. I've been building a lot of different builds off-screen that I've been having fun with, though, to help the monotonous grind feel a little bit less so. I made a nice gunblade build, I've been trying out to better design some greatsword, and of course, I finally got that goddamn contrary scale. So now I can throw hands at people. And it is just delightful. And then, the purpose of today, I'm going to finally kill the Rise Dragons. The Risen Elder Dragons, rather. That'll do. Play the title card and all that fun stuff. And either I will decimate them entirely, or they will murder me in instances. I'm very curious to see where on the spectrum I will fall there. Oh yeah, and I've also been grinding the living hell out of anomaly ranks off-screen for levels with that, but that's something else. So behold, first off we start with Risen Camellios and Risen Kushala, and then I apparently get something else at 140. I'm very curious to see what their armors look like, or if they even have new armors. I swear if it's another case of like, oh yeah, you just get an anomaly version of and then all the other normal materials, I will be very annoyed. Let's see. I got a Gore on the map, and I got a Raphlos. My spare weapons. Hey there. You're just in time for the hunting to begin. Actually, that reminds me. Just making sure. Let me check my stream info. Yep, it actually does recognize that it's Monster Hunter Rise. Boy, Twitch just really seems to have a problem with the Legacy Collection games and recognizing what the hell's going on with them, I guess. Weird. Oh, well, nothing insurmountable. Ah, here comes everybody. Can you tell I have this path memorized? Always get to your spirit birds first. Otherwise, you're just welcoming death. It's a little thing, but it makes all the difference. Never bother picking up Whale Nerd. He's just a sonic bomb, I found out, and I never use those anyway. Even if I really, really should. And there's my quarry right down there. So what's the deal with Risen Monsters? I know that they've taken down the affliction. Oh, he's paler. Interesting. I'll come take a closer look once I'm all geared up and ready to kill. But first, more of this. It's a bit of setup, but it's worth it, damn it. I swear it is. Hey there, Gory. Never-ending Gory. I'm using your own mitts. Assuming, of course, that you don't just decide to knock me out of the sky. Live to ride and ride to live. Don't you snap those jaws at me, you bastard. I'll also get a golden bug too, just because I want to see if a Rise Camellios gives unique materials. Here I come to end your day! Hey, Skelly. Just in time, I'm riding one world-ending dragon to kill another. Let's see how far you can rise up now! Hey, buddy. There it is. There you go. Don't you flick your tongue at me. I'm gonna shoot the hell out of you. So much free damage. There we go. That's right. Fall and die, Camellios. Fall and die. Whoa, that was... Oh, never mind. You just got knocked down again. Was he the original endgame? I know the rest of the Risen Monsters came out afterwards, but I have no idea the time frames involved. Oh, you got, like, a splotchy thing going. Are you a case of, like, oh, you're a monster who managed to survive your culling and then just got better? Oh. You are, like, weirdly veiny, and that kind of works with your purple texture. Whoa. And that's a very sudden jet beam. Hey, start a rise up with that Raphalos so I can get free damage, please. Thanks. You have only yourself to blame for this, Camellios. Now let me get some space. Come on, get out of there, Raphalos. There you go. You're not a bad ride. I just gotta get space. I need space! Learn from Tin Curry before you. Oh shit, your poison also subsists while I'm in ride. That's not great. Ah well, so far you still just seem like regular Camellios. Oh, come on. That's better. Keep me on track. I feel like I should heal as well. Oh, you got a hitbox now. So these are... Okay, so those are all just regular Camellios pieces. I really hope you're not a case of like, oh yeah, now... Wait, is there actually Risen Unique Armor? Or is this just, it's the same Elder Dragon, but harder now? Like anomaly stuff. Or the case of it just having like one unique new item to the mix. And one of those. Let's see. Well, whatever he's doing, he's crying a lot. That little bitch. Oh yeah, and unlike the last time you saw me, I'm now running a coalescence contrary build. Okay, you are very fast with the toxic. Oh, and your mist is silvery now? Weird. So far, these changes seem mostly aesthetic. And also that one, like, very fast poison shot. You're already rideable. Really? Well, alright, to the riding corner. Away. No, Raphalos, no. Oh, it is just a case of, okay, this is something that's afflicted, that's risen from the affliction. I feel like it said that in story, but it's been so long since I unlocked the message and ability to play these. And I've done nothing with that fact. Oh! Oh, so that's why he just exploded. right on fucking cue if you were explaining it in chat what risen mode apparently is. I was just wondering, why is there a fire cloud exploding around him? Oh, he's orange now.
Some humans could learn from you.
Huh. He seems more mushroomy now. Oh, come on. I wasn't even... I ran into your tongue. Oh, that's new. So you just have a poison super beam, and you trail yourself around in it? Okay, I'm glad I actually got some distance for a sec there. Very interesting. He loves trying to put himself into this narrow corner, though. Does not work to his advantage more often than not. Right this way, good sir. Yeah, man. That seems important. Oh! They're usable, you say? Oh, I see. Huh. It feels... the poison reach is interesting, but so far the things that are catching me more often than not are... what the hell was that? Whoa. I cannot get out of line with that for some reason. Weird. So far, the main thing that's hitting me is that his, whatchamacallit, wide hips that catch me in it. Oh, I knocked him out. I liked that cast off phase. Like, the orange miasmic haze seems super cool for him. So, is that just for all of them now, or is that specifically a hit? A Camellios color thing. I'm very curious now. I like Marks of Affliction. Oh wow, he can just go straight back into it. Oh, I see. So if I just do enough damage to him in a current time frame, then he does it. Then he goes into Risen mode. And then anything after that, it's just the new moveset. And before that, it's just the old one, but super buffed. Interesting! I really hope your armor is worth a damn. If there is one. Because so far, you just seem like Camellios and fast forward. Uh-oh. Fair enough then, good sir. Ignore that. What's this? Consequences of my words and actions? Crazy. Good sign that you got a faint off on me. Give me a mo to get some more health though. Just a smidgen. Okay, let's try that again. Attack and defense won't hurt, Beaver. There we go. Ooh, I do love me some peak performance. Also, good to know, good to have confirmation that there is in fact an armor set for him. I just realized as well, I haven't actually... what the fuck? I'm sorry, what? Two of those balls fucking knock me out at this level of health? The fuck? Zuh? Oh, wow. The world is just poison mist as well, too. I guess so. I didn't realize it was that big of a boost. Oh, was he having a nap? Just invisibly having a nap? Whoa, that was a longer tongue reach as well, too. Oh, you do a side-to-side thing now. Oh fuck, yeah, that's... Motherfucker! Wow, that escalated incredibly quickly. What the shit? Oh, I plundered a Gormagala mantle in there, apparently. okay. Well. Well. I was not expecting that. Okay, that actually changes some things. Let me try Kushala. I arguably can fight him better, but... Huh. I did not see that coming.
That'll do. The hunt is on.
Oh hey, I just realized there's no nameplate openings for the risen monsters. Okay, let's try this.
I'll put my heart and soul into helping our group succeed.
Ooh.
Sure. Okay.
Ooh, that sounds like a pretty good blessing. Don't tell me what Risen Kushala does. I want to find out what that does myself.
Hey, what's the matter?
Like, now that I know that Risen armor is in fact a thing... Because, like, I don't look up any of this shit until I decide to just do endgame myself. Ooh, I got a Rajang to work with, too. I still appreciate it as well, too. I hate getting stuck in this little cavern. Okay, I have slightly more health. Hopefully this time I will not get two shot. Part of me wants to open up with her Zhang barrages, but I kind of want to just see how this goes straight up. Oh, also he's in the boss-ass arena. I say. I mean, ideally with most armor sets, you aren't going to be hit at all with it, so it's just the benefits. Gotcha. Whoa, you are a fucking big Kushala, Jesus Christ. Look at the size of this lad. Oh, and you have fucking... That was not fire. Was that a rust beam? Yeah, he's just burping at me menacingly. No, but for real though, like this is... I think this is the fucking biggest Kushala Deora I've ever fucking seen. You did your drop down bullshittery on me. Whoa, that was close. In hindsight, you aren't super weak to dragon either. Yeah, man. That's right, stay in your corner. Your hitbox is nice and tight. It's in this place with zero visibility that I can murder you until you decide to face me outward. Then I'm in trouble. Whoa, is that more tornadoes than normal? I actually don't know. I don't usually fight a ton of Kushalas. I feel like that was two more than usual, though. Uh-oh. I see Black Dragon Mist. Oh, you got a reddish tinge to ya. You seem like at the halfway point between regular and rusted, Kushala. Oh, I love Doug Doug. I didn't know he was streaming right now. But welcome to the party, Supernatural. You're just in the time of watching me murder a giant wind dragon. Hopefully before it murders me. Oh god, he's burping. Come on. Let the damage numbers flow! Oh fuck. Not mine, not mine, not mine! Wow, that was an on-point fucking, bite from Kushala. Usually that thing goes, like, miles away. Ooh. Okay, so I got... It's interesting that I get the ride opportunity. I have not seen the text-to-speech on Melania. I am Melania. Hey, Mizitsu, I have a job for you. I have noticed the wider range of attacks. But I'm also noticing that I can still just go under him to avoid a lot of them. What I'm trying to do is crack open his head like an egg, or at least his back. Good boy, Mizitsu! Free damage! Wind effect isn't really something like that you had to worry a lot with dual blades. I will check out the stream later then. Sweet. Because thanks to my charging up, I mostly just go over the wind effects. Hey, I got a fart break though. Yay, there goes his wing privileges. Oh yeah, and the girls are also using, whatchamacallit, blunt weapons, which are great against his head. You're supposed to be the harder one, Kushala. Well, looks like we're about to go. Why is it that literally the second you talk about his Arise gimmicks, then he immediately goes into them? Oh, I see. He does knock-up streams. Gotcha. Like, literally, he's doing... Oh, I love the wind effect going around him, though. Oh, fuck. Oh, he's literally strong enough to rip up the ground beneath him now, too. And he's got a splash effect to his dives now. That's good to know. Shit, shit, shit. Whoa, that... I was in the radius of that, but it didn't hit me? I don't even know what his hitbox is anymore. The wind beams, at least, I can still just... Die for it. Nope, I just have invincibility frames from dual blades. Because Intrepid Heart didn't proc. Because the trick with Kushala wind stuff is that as soon as he tips his head upwards, you can dodge through it by moving towards it or to the side of it. That's Kushala's rule of thumb. Always has been, always will be. Like, I wasn't lying when I said I have an easier time fighting Kushalas than I do Camellios. If you have a sky-high weapon, then you can do a lot of fun shit with Kushala, like dual blades and Kinsect Glaive. My build definitely isn't too far past the Rise gimmick, because I'm using mostly Shagaru Magala armor for Bloodlust and Coalescence. That time there was a kaboom. Thank you. Here, I'll actually show off what my build is at the end of this, too. Here, buddy. I just really know Kushala Deordra's playbook. Come on. Assuming, of course, that his toes touch down close enough to the ground. It's not skipping anymore? Hey, that's great! Maybe Twitch had an update or something. I don't know what was causing that in the first place, even. Come on, Deodra, there's plenty of yummy, yummy bombs to run into over here. Wait, did we break his head at all? You know what, it easily could have been the same thing that caused the Games Plus demo. Oh wait, that might have been because... The reason I might be dealing damage to other parts is because I have critical boost on with insanely fucking high affinity from Coalescence Frenzy boosting. I've also already broken his back, which provides an ample target for me when I'm doing my twirlies to hit him. Like, not even kidding. So while I have... While I'm being frenzied, the little bar in the top left, I have Resentment active, boosting my general attack by plus 15, and then as soon as it resolves, then my affinity turns to raw 75, plus boosted by some of my skills, to over 100%, so every hit is a critical, or almost all of them. Ironically enough, not a lot, because more often than not, the monster dies before I can break everything. Unless I, like, really center in on a place. Whoa, I was right in his grundle. Hey, Kushala, I'm gonna take a quick break and bring back your doom. Note to self, do not turn my back on him. I'm gonna go get a very angry monkey. I will be back. We'll take a break here. I'm liking Kushala fights, though. Camellios just seems, okay, I'm trying to rebound away from this, and now I'm in another hit. Which I guess is the purpose, but come on. Tighty tighty toe, underground I go. I do like the Citadel map too with it. It's a fun little layout. It twists in on itself. I still have not figured out how to get to the top of this goddamn tree though. And da 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 da. Ironically though, I feel like the poison in Camellia seems to be the least deadly thing about him. It's just his multi-hit techniques. Work with me, Mr. Monkey Man! Not like that. I said work with me. Not kill me. I will say that Rajang's theme is always one of my favorites in any Monster Hunter title. Oh! Oh, gotcha. Right, because this isn't a raw element build for once. This is just straight up... This is just raw in general what I'm running with right now. Kill him! Fire at will, my monkey! Never doubted the power of strafing Ren Rajang. Especially with red Kinsec boosting. Ah. Let the bloodbath begin! I've still yet to break his head, though. Whoa, that's new. Oh! Oh, that was new! Oh, and he's got fisted. He's got Fist of the North Wind now. Okay, he's pulling out a bunch of new shit. Come on. Go for the head, boys! Are you ready? Claws is good, too. I'm sure somebody's been pissing in the wind somewhere in the world. That can't just be in the north. I do love just how wildly you flip out of control when you get hit by it. Kushala anything, though. Like, that was one of my favorite parts about Ibushi as a fight. And then you didn't really see it as much with Narwa, but it was there too. Oh, it's dead! Wow, that was a massive difference between Camellios.
I thought you were amazing.
I'm surprised I only actually broke his wings.
In fact, both of you were amazing. You've inspired me to work harder.
Neat. So, like, do they actually have Arisen materials, or is it just straight up normal Elder Dragon materials, but now I can do a Arisen armor set, I wonder? Why is my cat just hanging out in his skull? Ah, I'm not playing a blast build. This is pure this is Dragon Element with 390 free attack. With full agitator, critical boost, critical elements, and a smatter and a dragon attack. Then Partbreaker, Coalescence, and Bloodlust. Also, some sneak attack for those cheeky side shots. Oh, a unique gem. Let me guess, it has a 30% drop rate. Hey, look, I got a gem! Deora Rise Gem. Proof of having slain a Risen One, used for unlocking the Elder Dragon's hidden power. Ah, neat! Speak of the devil. You got a really good ability with that there. I obtained the Badge of Heroes. Wow, this... That just jumped me straight up. Neat. Okay, I want to see what this looks like. Yes, but first I eat. I've already got wing arms. Oh no, is it a... Does it look bad? Because if it looks bad, that's what layer armor is made for. Oh! Wow, that's disappointing. The waist piece looks cool, at least with, like, the little dragon decal, but... What the fuck are those shoes? They're, like, pointed LV. The chest piece, maybe, but, like... What the fuck is wind mantle? Using silk bind attacks boosts wire bug gauge recovery. Landing additional ones increases the attack. Oh, wears off when you sheath the weapon. Oh, that. All of these require the Rise Gem. Every single one of them. Whoa, those are some pretty decent slots, though. And then Kushala allows portions to recover and heat damage, etc., etc. The razor sharp you would expect. Burst 2. And then recovery up straight up from those, and then... Oh, wow. Okay, so I'm absolutely buying this. The helmet, because full wire bug whisper and activating the effect. I could see some amazing shit being done with this. Razor Sharp isn't ranged only. Spare Shot is range only, yes, but Razor Sharp applies to every weapon. Like, so long... I barely need to sharpen at all for my dual blades with it. The fact that the only other things with Wind Mantle have Burst, though. Is it possible to get Wind Mantle as a decoration, maybe, or... Oh, Flawless Jewel, Kushala Blessing Jewel. Just as a one slot? Oh, wow. Oh, so does that mean I'll be able to get those done for Teostra and Camellios as well, too? Because they're definitely just going to do the trio. Oh, that's cool.
Hey there. Okay, then. See you soon. Let's begin, shall we?
And no, I don't have it on this list. I thought now that I knew it was a thing, but like, Wind Mantle, huh? Interesting. So I assume that's super fucking good for, God, I can already think of like Gunblade, Lance, maybe Hammer, like depending on how you play it, because if you're just keeping it out forever, then you could just keep going through it. Aww. Still, I can... That's not bad. Alright, let's give Camellios another try.
Let us begin.
Aw. Is it possible to make them in a Wind Mantle Talisman, then? If I can't make it into a jewel? Because, like, for what I'm picturing is that feels so, like, weirdly stilted if you can't, because the whole... Because, like, with... Having that tied in with Burst feels weird. Because most of the elemental procers I can care to name are, like, faster weapons, and then you resheath them. Actually, that then again... Once I unsheath my dual blades, it's rare that I resheath them outside of, like, very specific moments. So that could actually be very good. Hmm. Okay, I'm curious now. Oh yeah, also, once I get to the top of this cliff, I'm checking the drop rate on that Deora... On that Rise Deora gem. I still don't get why Apexes get their own section at the very end here, and then everything else. Delicious steak. Da da da. Large Geo Gem. Oh, 7% find. Must become strong like Hinoa. Interesting.
Perfect as usual.
Okay, so it's not unfathomably hard to find. That's at least something kind. Oh god, it took me so fucking long to find... Yeah, Kushala Blessing is definitely super niche. But like, it's very good if you combine it with different... If you're after Ice or Wind Elemental, but yeah. Then all of the blessings in this game are super weird and like, kinda stilted. There you are. Like, they don't really get good until the end levels, and even then, they're more, like, situational. They're about the closest you can get skill-wise to putting in rock, paper, scissors in a game. Yeah. The heat damage thing sounds more impressive than it is, because you realize, okay, there's only two monsters in this game who do it, and one of them is Teostra. And then I think the other one is Angina? Question mark? Spuckin. You made me miss my target, Raphalos. Jesus. Thank God I can, parallel park. Oh, come on. You got up just as I directed my slashy forward. Yeah, pretty much all of them are made to counter each other. Like, Camellios's heat resistance is anti-Teostra. Teostra's got wind immunity for Kushala, and then Kushala has... you can no longer be stolen from, if I remember right. And Camellios is literally the only one who steals from you. Because that's his whole gimmick, the probing tongue. This guy's a lot more willing to get space, I've noticed. Like, regular Camellios, he does it occasionally as well too, but more often than not, he's just trying to crush you under his bulk. Not this guy. And that's an interesting change to me. He feels more like a special attacker than a physical attacker now. That's the best way I can put it. There you go. The poison stream! Was I dealing 113 damage a pop to your head? Oh, I was hitting the wings. I don't know. Like, I feel it... because the poison isn't what's killing me. It's the sheer amount of damage each little orb was doing as I tried to avoid the first one and would be knocked into the second one. That was what amounted to two of my three carts. Oh yeah, that also reminds me. Hills are his bane. Hills and subtle slopes. I like to imagine that it's because he's an elder dragon who's rarely seen. Let's look at a chameleon. What do they look like? I don't know, kinda little idiots. You're a genius! What'd I say? Good job, Gary. I like that Camellios is a little derpy, though. It makes it all the more threatening when he crushes you to death under his massive ass. Hey, Raphalos, I'm voluntolding you. Oh, son of a bitch, you just left. You asshole! I also just love that he sometimes has a lie down while invisible, like, I'll just be here and no one has to know. Like, presumably he was just in the shrine ruins for years, fucking asleep, and no one never noticed him because he's goddamn invisible and killed everyone who found him. Oh, he's exploding. He's come down with a case of explosions! I feel like I'm doing more damage once he's there. Exactly, when in doubt, set him on fire. No, it did not, because I'm... whoa, I'm fucking jittering! I'm jittering! I think the explosion effect isn't supposed to be, like, damaging to me, it's just supposed to be a knockaway effect. Because the same thing happened with Kushala, where it would happen, but it didn't really do much to me. He's got a lot more follow-up stuff. That's the main takeaway of Camellios. He's gotta rise up, rise up! Here we go, here comes the General Camellios! I can't tailspin into your, tail? That's disappointing. Whoop, and there goes the kaboom. I feel like I'm better off just kinda... working away at murder on these guys and then going for rides at the end when they really start to kick it into overdrive. And that time I didn't react because I had Intrepid Heart active. and that's why you always carry herbal medicines. Visit your local gypsies today. Like, as I've still yet to do a ride, and I've already popped him out in and out of Risen once. I wonder if you just have a little invisible meter in your head that says, oh, I've taken this much damage, now's the time to pop, or if it's just like, okay, this has gone on this long. Oh, that time I didn't even get knocked away because I was in the right animation for my spiral blow. Delightful. Where did you go, motherfucker? There you are. He likes to do a lot of teleport behind you bullshit. Or try to, at least. Now that I know your toolkit, I'm not... Whoa, okay. I feel like I should maybe be running. Yeah, I'm sheafing myself more for you just because I have to keep fucking dealing with your poison shit, not because of my playstyle. Oh, you got knocked down. You won't get up again, I swear it! I still haven't really been breaking anything off these motherfuckers. You must be really hardy. Oh, there goes the Camellia shattering kaboom. I'm not damage pacing as well as I really could be if I could spiral strike a six. There goes the tail! And his face! Oh wait, no, his claw, never mind. Whoa, I landed on the roof. I climbed him like a ladder. Wow, you are, How the hell did I die to you before? I feel like you were just combo juggling me before, and now it is I who has you. Break that horn off! See? Thank you. It always pays to be polite and ask. He did use a lot more of his poison techniques, yes. He came a little close there. Thank you, RNGesus. You are a kind and merciful god when you decide to be. Just like regular god, but with surprisingly more consistency. Eh, while you set up your bombs, I'll just do this. Give me your tail! It's still always weird to me that this is what constitutes his tail. Like the fucking little ringlet end. I know, right? God bless you, RNGesus. Oh no, I've lost my horn. Yeah, like a broken horn Camellios is just a nerd. Give me your horn, dweeb! Watch out for this monster that I'm throwing at you bodily. Ah. You're coming down with an awful case of explosions, Camellios. Whoa, as am I, apparently. Some humans could learn. Okay, I see what happened. Intrepid Heart activated and it saved me from the poison beam, but that just left me fully intact to get the... I guess it wouldn't be a Risen monster if it didn't have its own personal pocket nuke. Classy. Oh well, one feint out of three. I almost said four, but that's not right at all. Not you, Gore. You can relax for now. You take a load off, good sir. You were a fine weapon. But now you're getting retired. No, I'm after a bigger fryer. I tried to get him on board before. Is he fucking following me? Yes, he is. Wow. I did not notice. I did not look behind me. Come here, you stupid shit. Ride him! Ah, that's better. So yeah, worked you over a little bit, but you kept the bar warm for me. Now here I come, dead eyes. I'm gonna roast you on this park. What I sang made no sense at all, but it rhymed vaguely so it stands. You're king of the skies of nothing, Rapalos. Oh, son of a bitch. What the hell was that? You didn't fire off the beam you were building up or the end mount that I was rapidly smashing it for. You're a disappointment, Rapalos. You're king of the skies because no one else bothered to show up to the election. Wait until fucking Amatsu hears about you. Good, let him. Do you know how many, do you know how little that matters to me? He poison nuked again. He puked again. Whoops, I don't have red energy. You have to basically pick up the horn? I thought it was just a... Oh, I feel like I picked up the material, yeah. Hooray, he's dead!
We did it?
Okay, that wasn't too bad, with only one faint.
What did you think of my hunting today, Hinoa?
Blech!
I thought you were amazing. You make me proud to be your sister.
I'm seeing that, yeah. Why am I not... Let me carve him.
You inspired me to work harder.
Yeah, because, like, tails always show up on the overworld as their actual items, but a lot of the time, broken materials just show up as, like, little sparklies on the ground. So that the game doesn't have to render every single piece of a monster every time you start a quest with them. You know what? I'm proud of this. Everybody say cheese! There's something very sinister about a picture of a smiling girl next to a brutalized monster. Like, his face is broken in, his tongue is hanging out, bits of his tail are missing. Say cheese!
Another successful hunt!
Ah, yeah. Ooh, I got two of his gems. Hey, one in each of his hearts. Nice. Greetings from our local conquest. I wonder what the hell the odds are of getting two as a bonus reward. Oh, and a platinum egg. Pure money. Delicious. Ooh, and I'm nearly a level 140, too. When I get the third one, I assume. Okay, let's see what Risen Camellios looks like.
Hey, good to see ya!
Risen Mizuha. Peak performance, evasion window... What the fuck is build-up boost? Okay, see, this I actually kinda like a little. The shoes, I'm still wondering what the fuck, given like... Look at those elf-ass toe curls. But I kinda like... I like the jiggle on the shoulder piece, the little diamond core in the center. What is the helmet?
I have been
oh, it's just a circlet.
Ever since I was little.
Okay.
I could say I'm
gym slots aren't bad, but aren't great.
Don't worry about your gear.
Let's find out. No, actually, the horn is nowhere present in the tails are nowhere present with the shoes. They might be based off them, though. Oh, wow, yeah, that is really weak to fire. Okay, what the fuck is build-up boost? Increases attack power when you land attacks that build explosion. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so that's... Wow, that's really good. Especially if you're running poison, like, damn. Poison especially, but blast, you can do some awful things with that. Okay, so, oh, but it only caps out at 20%. Okay, so I'm already seeing some synergies. Oh yeah, and just straight up maximum peak performance out of this bitch. Yeah, that seems really good. The fact that the chess piece is only a 4-slot, though, that's not great. What was Furry again? Increases when afflicting attack. Hooray seems more useful than the actual bit. I think I'm gonna buy this one just for the wire bug whispers in the foray. And then I have another one. What should I buy? Should I buy the legs or should I buy the headdress? Because it's definitely not gonna be the robes. What do you guys think? Hit it is! Yeah, because I can definitely build a lot with this. I feel like I'm gonna just buy not this guy or this guy, but I'm definitely gonna get the wind mantle stuff.
Hey, thanks.
Okay, so those are the two risen monsters I have unlocked, and then the third one I can only assume comes at 140. So let's just raise myself up 2 damn levels with that, and then...
Back to work.
And then see how that goes from there. So let's go kill another, Risen. Oh, I can only bet that it would get insane very quickly. Because, like, I'm already thinking, like, okay, you do Gunblade, Burst Barrage for Wirebug skills, or 2 up, and then, oh, you just have it back, you shield for a few seconds, it's everything's back, you do it again. That's 2,000 damage a pop each. Let's go kill another Kershala.
The hunt is on.
Aw, man, I'm already getting excited for these. It would be hilarious if I get another 2 gems and it's just everything I need. I'm hoping that's how it goes, because I'm on stream. Let my luck guide me.
Really?
And I still have Rajang beams as well to shoot off. I'm glad I waited to do both of these in the same stream, however, though, too, because, like, it's nice to directly compare all of these together. And it took me a fucking while to level up, too. Like, to this point. Monster Hunter is always gonna be one of those games that, like... It doesn't feel like a slog playing the game with it. Sometimes, certain parts of it can be, yes, absolutely, 100%, but, like, there's always gonna be a level of enjoyment here. Like, this is a game that I can pick up for a few hours at a time and just enjoy myself with, and then go back to doing something else. Like, for instance, you wanna know a real slog within which there is no enjoyment beyond the trophy hunt? Mega Man Battle Network chip grinding. Oh my fuck, I'm still doing that shit. I've managed to trade a few people here and there for some stuff, but overall, it is just a shit show trying to hunt things down in that.
Are you ready? Is it going to hurt?
Come here, Espy. There we go. Oh, hey, neat, he's coming to me. Let us dance this dance of death and pain. Here he comes, Mr. Shala. Dance with me in this dance of death and pain! Ironically enough, Espinas, very good ride finisher, not super effective ride attack. Sure, he does the job kinda if you let him do the full attack, but more often than not, you're gonna get interrupted unless he's already down. But that Ender, oh boy. That 1600 pop damage, that's fire affliction, fire blight, paralysis. It's the whole damn gambit. You fool, I have a maximum plus affinity, Kushaler. Yeah, more often than not, Kushala's hitbox is right underneath him. The Weeb's Gambit. I know your every move before you're gonna make it. But no, I'm not playing Weeb's Gambit. I'm not doing Longsword. Out of every Monster Hunter game, that is the one weapon I have never once tried to play. And I don't feel like I'm missing much. When you have to physically dedicate slots to okay, I'll do this so I'm not an ass to everybody else I'm playing with. That's never a great sign. Oh, you know what? That's a very good way to put it. There are very few anime games that I enjoy. Because more often than not, they're just so fucking highly questionable. Oh, damn it, I forgot that's where the other guy was. One Piece Odyssey, that was a rare gem, and even it had its flaws here and there. The only ones that I've seen done, super well that I know off the top of my head are JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, it was the Eyes of Heaven. Because we're going for the story of JoJo with everyone. Wonderful work, my friend. Thanks for the support. Sengoku Basara is not bad. I'm not a super fan of the Free Kingdom stuff. So much has been done with it, yes, but it all just blends together after a point. You know, fair enough with that for the Warrior Saga. Keep it up, keep it away. Once I finish up Mega Man ZX, I think I'm going to do... I think I'm going to finish up... Persona Strikers. That sounds about right. A lot of the Warriors titles, get caught up in other shit. There's always a gimmick per each game that they have to include in, and then, that just kind of takes over everything. Or sometimes it's just you get bogged down by so many characters that some just are shit. Whoa, okay, so that one hit me dead on. I see. So that's what it's supposed to do. How the fuck did that not hit me before then, though? Weird. Exactly. Hey, you have a turf war? Yo, funny monkey man choke slamming him. Oh shit. Whoa, you caught me out of midair with that. Got you. Get monked on! Honestly, for games I want to play this year, I love a good skill-based game where you can really get to, like, combos going if you know the characters and how the attacks function. Like, there's a time when you really want something skill-based, and there's a time when you're like, okay, I push this button and now I do this cinematic-ass attack. Depends on the day in question. Where did you go, Kushala? Oh, you got knocked back. What knocked you out of Risen mode? Oh, come on. The one downside to a Kushala fight is that it's hard to get very good cinematic shots because you gotta be all right up in them. Right up in, on, and under. Oh, come on. You flexed your neck and you bit me? All right, I remember you were telling me about punching Grey Raven. Excellent opportunity. God, it has been years since I've played fucking Bejeweled. I feel like clones of it were fucking everywhere for a while there with it, especially in DS games and the like. And then that just kinda stopped? Which I'm glad for, but it was weird that it happened in the first place. I guess so. Now everything is a Candy Crush clone to this new generation. It might also be the fact that, like, I don't look at phone games anymore, like, even a little bit. Like, I had no idea Honkai Star Rail came out until people talked about it in chat, and then I saw ads for it on YouTube. But when I was little, like, when I was super little, I didn't really have, like, consoles and the like, or rather, I had consoles, but I didn't use them for video games. Like, my Wii U, I would use that shit to surf the internet and YouTube. I was one of the rare few who bought a Wii board. Okay, that's at least slightly better. I never once touched FGO, though. Like, I'm always still a little leery of those games. Because I know I'm a person with addictive tendencies and the willingness to just deep dive into shit if at the slightest provocation. Like, you're talking to the guy who tapped the Simpsons Tapped Out. The mobile phone game, the freemium phone game. I got to level 355. And to the point where every level was just automatically one a day, if not more, because of the sheer depth of characters I accumulated from playing every day for like 3 years. No excess donuts used or bought, just straight up the sheer amount of time. Here's the thing, what I like in stories is deep, convoluted lore. And that's just the Fate series in a nutshell. Yeah. My trick was like, okay, in this game you have to assign tasks? Okay, I'll do the 8-hour ones. I go to bed, wake up in the morning. Oh yeah, I love deep convoluted lore, especially if it invalidates other deeper lore. Often in the same time it's introduced. Give up and die, Kushala. You might have the high ground, but you also have the die ground. I feel like I've heard about that. 13 Sentinels. Isn't that the one where there's like a mech? It's a world of mechs or some shit, or some teenagers are in a world and they find a mech? Why did you just do your deep dive? Oh, that's why it didn't hit me before, because you shot it forward and I was just out of the sphere range. Interesting, I'll look into it. I think once I'm finished my backlog of games here with it, like Hogwarts Legacy, Persona Strikers, that shit, then I'm going to do, I think the South Park games, because they're surprisingly short, but super funny. Ooh, I do love me a very complex non-linear multi-pov story. You're saying plenty of my buzzwords right now, buddy. I'll also finish Persona 3 at some point, like, as a playthrough of it, but it's just... the reception of that is, like, weirdly mixed. Because people are either really into it or not at all. Hey, wow! I shaved off an entire minute of killing you.
Just what I expected from the hero of Kimura.
I wonder how the hell that happened.
You were great too, Minoto. How about we celebrate with some dongo? I've already made the
oh boy, I got one type of gem from him.
Delivered by now. Let's make our way back. How about we get going soon?
Wait, what? Wait, hang on. That doesn't seem right. Oh, absolutely, it has some problems to itself. Oh. I somehow found the rarer gem from him. I got it's a 4% chance to find the large Elder Dragon gem, but a 7 for Deora. Damn it, I was too lucky for my own good. It's nice that I have options at least to my content. I see some people who like, oh yeah, I'm doing a... this Slay the Spire run for the 300,000th time, and I just can't do that. I get that they're roguelike options, and yeah, you can replay it, but there's only so much. Oh, they can only come from the reward screen? I don't know, man. It was saying it could be found with whatchamacallit as well, too, a 3% drop rate. That's how I got Contrary Scale. I swear, I don't even know why I send you guys out anymore. You never show up with anything useful, mercenaries. Give me more free shock traps. Hey, I finally killed enough. You're right, I'll have it displayed in middle fingers, to proudly stand on top to everybody who makes me feel small. I have so many Lagni apples and nothing to spend them on.
Hey, good to see ya!
Na-da-da! Amazing Kushala! I'll go with the pants. Actually, hang on. I want to make something right here. Because I've been working on gunbladery. So I got this 300 damage blast gunblade with it. Let's see. Rise up. Wirebug Whisper for those. Definitely don't want Embolden. Maybe Intrepid Heart and Razor Sharp. So that leaves Chest Please. Critical Boosted and Agitator aren't super important. Definitely not Resentment, Jesus Christ, no. Not you. Actually, no, definitely not that. Does Blast Attack? No, that doesn't count for Surge. Once I have the other Risen set, this will be a no-brainer, but for now, definitely not Charge Master. I'll stick with Lucent. Okay, so now this gives me full Wirebug Whisper. Actually, wait, do I double up on Wirebug Whisper from everyone? Not you. Let's see. So that's full. Oh, that actually gives me more than that. Oh, Skyrim is another fun one I could do. That is true. Okay, so I don't need Risen Mizuha, because I already have full of that. And Foray is not important. I could go with Artillery. I've never actually played Oblivion. What did Melee Hellfire do? Increase defense by increase attack. Actually, that's not bad. Or maybe because that gives Coalescence. Actually, wait, no, hang on. I can do things with load shells. I can do awful things with that. Oh, is it? How do you level skills in Oblivion? I legitimately don't know. Okay, now I'm going to... I got full load shells in that. Oh, so you actually just have to just keep using them until they level up or something? Gotcha. I do like Coalescence. Get running. Ah, I see. Wow, I would just jump fucking everywhere. Okay. There will be much jumping to be had. Okay, let's see. Kripweaver is definitely important. Master's Touch. Oh, if I could get Pokemon working, I would go for Pokemon. Oh man, I actually have the dot hack thing. Like, I got the collection set with it, but I never actually finished it because I don't know, I just kind of got started on other things. Where the fuck was my... Not Quick Switch. I could have sworn I had a Jumping Jewel. Okay, that's better. Now I have actual ability names. I don't know why I was struggling there. Oh, Jump Master's a free slot? Well, alright then. Finally, something decent in there. Oh, trust me, I know what goes on with Dot Hat with it. Like, that shit, yeah. That's some convoluted shit. Not so much worth it with that. You could go for full stamina feat to tire him out. Where did my critical boosts go? There you are. Oh, yeah, man, like, I literally went for the entire first game of Dot Hack. Like, trust me when I say I'm aware that it gets really good. Okay, and then my free slot, this isn't Elemental, this is... Gears of War, that's something to keep in mind. Okay, so this is a good set. Okay, I kind of want to try this out in training for a sec. Okay, so let's see if this works how I think it works. Whoa, okay. Oh, so green. And you do your quick charge, you attack for a little bit. I've never actually heard of Black Book before. Ooh, I do like me some ology. Okay, so that's pretty decent. Ooh, I do like management. Okay, that's a little bit unwieldy when I'm right up there. I think I want some... Okay, this is definitely off to a good start, Gunblade-wise. I like it. Ooh. I like the sound of that. Hey, you want to know a good game that's, like, critically underrated? The Witch and the Hundred Knight. It's by Nippon Ichi Software, the same guys who do Disgaea. It's pretty good. Two-part series, they came out with a dedicated collection the other year. I like them. I have still yet to play Disgaea 6. Which feels like a shame to me, but just something about the gimmick didn't appeal to me. Like the, oh yeah, you can just set this down and we'll level up for you. Like, I get why, but that's not why I play a Disgaea game. I play a Disgaea game just so I can personally make my guy the most powerful being in existence. That's why no one alive except for the no-lifers has ever successfully platinumed a Disgaea game. Like, get to the fucking end of an item world, Jesus Christ. 9 million floors. Oh yeah, I heard about that. I have considered the Fate Extra games. Those could be a lot of fun. I got a lot of potential fun stuff coming out. Like, even if it isn't new stuff necessarily, I guarantee you it will be fun stuff. Was it at least the good... You think I have a problem with samey games? Look at what I'm playing right now! Look at what I'm fighting and murdering! Nah, it can be. Don't knock rock, paper, scissors. If you can knock rock, paper, scissors, obviously you've never played the original Dinosaur King game for the DS. Oh, fuck that game. If you ever want to just have an aneurysm on demand, play that game. Or the Beyblade game for Game Boy Advance. The one that was so poorly mistranslated that they didn't even bother to keep in the starting instructions on how do you spin your Beyblade. But literally how the Dinosaur King game played if it was... Wait, is Fate Extella not Fate Extra? Because that's the one I was thinking of, the beat-em-up. Because that's Mooncell stuff, right? If I remember correctly. I know of things. Ah, I see. Gotcha. Good to know. I'm learning so much. Oh, that's where I was getting mixed up. Okay, so it's a... Whoa. I can see why, just from the bass sounds of it. I really want to figure out a way to, like, get to those old Game Boy games running, just so you can see the shit I explain and talk about in disbelief here. Because, like, I'm not lying when I say that Beyblade game fucking broke me. To the point where I was so annoyed one day that I threw it behind the couch, never to be seen again. And then I moved and saw it again. And that was my go-to move for some reason. Probably pretty good, but I just don't think anybody has ever bothered to make an emulation of it. Because I'm talking like these are shit-tier games. That maybe spent a week in a workshop to be crudely translated and then were never looked at again. You know what? I probably would be surprised. Oh, what the fuck? I got knocked against his chest. Good for you, Kushala. Fair enough. Oh man, that... I don't know why that was my go-to move as a kid, though, if it, like, when I... If I fucking hated a game. Jade Empire? Never heard that one before. Anyway, if I just hated a game, back behind the couch it went. Like, no hesitation, I'm done with you now. And I only ever did it to two games. Three games. I only ever did it to three games. One was the GBA Game Blade. Ooh, I do like the Dragon Age guys. The second was Surf's Up, the game for the Game Boy Advance, like the movie tie-in game about those surfing penguins that I had, that I think I got for my fifth or sixth birthday. And the whatchamacallit. Oh god, this is gonna really date me right here. Oh yeah, no, it was not a good game. And the Wii? No, it wasn't the Wii version. Fuck, I remember what it was. It was the Portal Watch version of Fairly Odd Parents. Like, so it was a... They were little GBA cartridges that just had an episode of a show on them. A single show. And I remember hating it with a passion because, like... Oh yeah, no, like, that's the thing. I loved it the first time, but then... The compression rate and all of it was just got so awful each time I watched it. Because I got it, because, like, I would go... We were going on a road trip, and, like, here, this'll keep... You'll enjoy this for a little while. And the first time, it was great, but then... I don't know what the fuck happened. Maybe I jangled it or something, or something went loose in it, but... Like, every few minutes after it would start playing normally, it would just let out this awful, ear-piercing ringing, and I hated it. So back behind the couch it went. To the shame corner. Son of a bitch, Kushala. It tried to... There's gotta be a way to turn off that adjustment fucking thing. That targeting system. Because it didn't hit Rajang, it just curved me right into the hole, goddammit. Oh, I've heard of Drakengard. Thank you. You know, I'd also be down to do a, like, a... not a full playthrough of Fallout 4, but maybe just for, like, a casual stream every now or then with it, like... because I could have fun with that. We could all make a stupid character abomination as Bethesda do. Oh yeah, I refuse to touch Fallout 76, though. Fuck that. I could get New Vegas. Because that one, they actually still sell in the PS store. The point I'm making is, like, I'd be down to do that. Is it? I've never actually played New Vegas. Good to know. But yeah, I feel like that's... I've got a whole bunch of stuff I want to do this year and a stuff that I'd like to see done this year. Because, like, new games will definitely be coming out, but there's so many fun older games that I feel like I could experience with everybody. Wait, my spiral lock can stun people? What the fuck? How have I never figured out that before? Huh. Ooh, I do love actually mattering choices. It's stupid what happened with Telltale. Like, they really just jumped the shark and just decided to be assholes to everybody. I'm really glad they went out of business. Aw, oh, man, there was a point and click game that was really good with consequences that whose name escapes me now, but I loved playing it as a kid. Hey, is Cartoon Network game still a site? Because if it is, I might just do a day of that. Assuming, of course, that I eventually get a gaming PC this year. Or rather, one that I feel confident streaming on. Aw, oh, man, some of those fucking games there, like... what would happen is I would finish things in class, and then I would just go on to, an approved site, because I knew, yeah, no, this is just fine. The teachers know what I'm about. Like, I'm not doing anything crazy or illegal or, like... I guess people would play GTA and shit and not that it's been downloaded on the computer for ages by... Oh, I loved the Stormhawks game. The one that immediately, that my mind jumps to was Gummy Bear Bouncer. Where you were this weird-ass wrestler having to break out of Candyland by thrusting yourself forward. Oh, Valkyria Chronicles? I think I like them. It's been ages since I thought about them, but I'm fairly certain I enjoyed it. Oh, right, there's a rock that I can throw down onto people. I have never once done that, though. There's also the Tales of series, like the... wait, was it Tales of or Trails of Cold Steel? Like, those things are fucking massive.
Thanks for the support.
What just happened? I feel like I got reoriented there.
It's weekend, oh. Let's take advantage.
I gotta say, though, like, between Risen, Kushala, and Camellios, I'm definitely loving Kushala more. If only for the color scheme. Yeah, though I've never actually played the Legends of series myself. I've only ever seen playthroughs. Trials of Cold Steel, that's it. I've really got to get a Steam membership. There was also... Ah, fuck. I'm choking on the name of it, but... I want to say... No, it's not SpongeBob Ready for Action. That sounds like a porno title. It was one of the age-old point-and-click adventures of my super early childhood. I've talked about them a bit before, but I definitely want to see if I can find that again this year and share with you all. Because, like, the animation is awful now, but the humor is actually pretty good. Ah, he broke his head. Oh, yeah, also, if I manage to get two Risen Jewels with this set, then that does correlate to, like, okay, each time you break a body part, then you get a jewel. I don't think it was Employee of the Month. I remember it was a Flash point and click game. You could go into the Mermalair and play. You had to cinematically beat an old woman with. It definitely wasn't the movie, the game. Like, I remember that much. Let's see. You know what? Overlord could be fun, too. All I remember is you have to... It had, like, a shockingly large amount of locations in it, because, like, you could go back in time, you could go... fucking straight for Jellyfish Fields, you went to the Mermalair. It was great. I loved it. Original voice actors, too. It wasn't Back in Action. Fuck. This is gonna bother me. You know what? I'm going to look it up and then later post it on the Persona story chat and let everybody be super confused, except for you, you guys who are here now to answer the question. People will think it's just me putting in the wrong chat, but no, it will be correct. This is for my sake, not yours, not theirs. There he goes. Aw, the time that I saved killing you the other time went into this time. I feel like Risen monsters are just fucking massive, too.
You make me proud to be your sister. In fact, both of you were amazing. You've inspired me to work harder.
There we go. Now, this should take me to 140 as well, I believe. Or I hope. Let's see. No, wait, never mind. I'm only 138. Fuck. Okay, I gotta do one more. I don't think I'm gonna kill another Deodra. I think I'm just going to... Maybe I'll kill another Camellios. Or just do some actual non-risen fights for a sec. Oh yeah, my full build right now is... Ooh, that's not bad.
And I've still got room to grow.
Excellent.
I've never actually played a Red Dead game. Oh, I just got a regular Deodra gem. Hi-Fi Rush is another good one. There's a ton of good games out in the world. That's the thing. It's hard to go wrong with any of them.
Strike while the iron's hot. Okay, good luck.
True. I feel like I do have Battle for Bikini Bottom rehydrated. This is a fact. You guys are just a... I feel like I'll do that for a summer stream. Like, maybe mid-June, early July or some shit. Because, like, it's time for a pool party. Let's do some rehydrated. Something like that shit. Hey, you know what? Let's go. Let's go, screw up with a monkey and a basil. And I'm gonna switch out from the dual blades. Exactly, my summer special. All my summer games. Let us begin. Damn it, I could have done that for the Shantae series. I should have waited for the summer Shantae series. Summer Shantae special. Damn you, marketing degree. Why didn't you work for me there? Damn you, marketing degree that I don't have. Why didn't you help me? Last time I checked, I'm not a monster. Well, check again. You have been possessed too many times, Minato. Ooh, pixel art, you say? Luna Lux, that rings a bell. Oh, hey, I could play Death's Door. That was a fun little roguelike that came out a while ago that I didn't really see a lot of people talk about. It was fun. For next year, eh? What was that one game about choosing wands and customizing them that never came out to... why did you not roar? Why did you just go straight to attacking me? You asshole, Basil Geese. Basil, you prick! Oh well, let's see how this do. I remember seeing, like, a few different people, streamers I follow, play it, but I never actually found what it was called myself.
Any last words?
Come on.
You're in danger. Are you ready?
Damn it, I'm missing. Oh, come on, I was going away from that. As you can see, my explosive kebab here is a little bit slower than dual blades, but he still hits pretty mightily. Whoa, why were you just flying into that wall, Basil?
This is going to hurt.
Stop just fucking walking away from me mid-combo. Stop hitting me and let me hit you. It's only fair, dammit. Come on. For a guy who's based off a B-52 bomber, you're kind of a bitch. Aw, come on. I was swinging already. That's better. Okay, now I'm getting into my groove. This is Bitch 52 coming in live. I'm still surprised I'm allowed on the air. That's the worst radio persona I've ever heard.
Any last words?
Ah, that's the earth-shattering kaboom. The basil-breaking kaboom. Oh, come on. You raised your head just out of reach. You prick. I still don't think I'm ever going to do a playthrough of Persona 4, though. An excellent opportunity. I love the game, I do, but it's just too many things on it are problematic. Especially because you never know who's going to watch it and take the wrong thing or joke into a logical extreme in this point of the internet. Like, it's too frisky for me. Which is a shame. But, like, it's just the frank reality of it. I can just play it in my own time. I enjoy it there. I know what I do, and I like... And that's all it is. That's right, intrepid me heart. So yeah, after ZX Advent, it's gonna be... I'm gonna end Hogwarts Legacy and Persona Strikers just so those are off the ballots, and then I'm going into a bunch of fun stuff. I think I'm gonna look into getting a copy of Fallout 3. Or, not a copy, like it. See if I can work out that. Because I do! The Fallout series has a lot of good humor to it, and that's what I like. Oh, I took his tail off somehow. At some point. Just now. As well as that, I got a bunch of other little things, like, already in the wings, getting geared up as well, too. Like, just the other day, I got Lego Harry Potter again. Ah, son of a bitch, you know. You pushed him out of my strike zone. I do like my double swing for blast procs. And he's dead! Came down with an awful case of death.
I shall put this to good use.
There we go. Do I want the rest of this? Not really. I killed it, didn't even bother to take its spoils. What an awful human being I am, temporarily.
It pays to care for your weapon.
My weapon deserves proper care.
But outside of what will be and what might be, how's everybody else doing today? Enjoying the stuff that I'm putting out? I say it like I'm Oh right, I need to physically get a thing for like, okay yeah. You got a follower now, you got a... How about you all fill the silence? I need to figure out how to get a chat box running. There's a lot of things I gotta look into as a Oh, Rajang is too fucking small for my bursty balls to hit. Well, I can guess I just do chargies. Take the bite! Ah, your laser means nothing to me in my invincibility stage. That's better. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Ah, sounds good, Skelly. Thanks for stopping by, man. I appreciate it. God, Rajang is just unending violence. And I respect him for it. But I'd respect him more if he wasn't trying to leave my guts all over the floor. Also, I never really noticed it before, but he has fucking steam vents on his arm.
This is going to hurt! It's up to something!
Where are you aiming, boy?
Are you ready?
Oh, hear the ominous chorus intensify. Maybe I'll try it. No, I'm not gonna give Hunt Bloodborne another try. That does weird things to my brain. Ironically. Not the things you're expecting. It just puts me into weird headspaces writing-wise. So it would only be like a one or the other thing. I'm considering giving Sekiro another chance, but on the other hand, I also kind of just want to say fuck it on that. Like, some gameplay styles just don't fit with you as a gamer, and I accept that. I even said it last stream, a good rule of thumb is never start something you don't see yourself being able to finish. Not unless you can clarify well and like truly from the start, like, yeah, no, this is just a one-off to say I've done it and to show you all what it is about. That is a different situation entirely. One is promising yourself to do something you will struggle at and probably not enjoy. The other is just, okay, I'm showing off of what this is. And a lot of people struggle with that. Like, it's one thing when you and your off time are playing a game and decide, okay, no, I'm gonna do this until it's just not fun anymore. And hopefully that's a rare situation for you, but when it's when you're trying to make a career out of it, you gotta have some follow through if people are gonna pay attention to you. Oh, come on, your rear back. Oh, there you are. There you are, funny monkey man. We're nowhere near the village. You're not getting near the village. We're on an entire separate landmass, you know. Na 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 na, right in the stupid monkey face.
Are you ready?
Why did that not? Oh god, he grabbed me! Oh god. Oh, but it's not raging, Rajang, so there's no laser to the face. That's lucky at least. He did have a mild tracking with that. Fair enough then. Oh, come on. I gotta start fighting you with great swords more, Rajang. Come on. Don't be like that, buddy. Oh god. Come on, haven't we been over this enough? Thank you. Alright, no, you aren't raging, Rajang. You can actually fall into shock traps. See? Hey! Oh!
It's all over for you.
Did you literally just get... Oh, come on. You turned back to normal just in time to not be hit by the trap? You prick. Oh, but you're weak already. Unfortunately, I can't adjust to it enough. Oh, never mind. I still clipped your tail. Lucky! Yay, it's dead.
That was surprisingly easy.
Okay, now this should push me over to 140. Maybe. If not, then this, then one more.
I thought you were amazing. You make me proud to be your sister. In fact, both of you were amazing. You've inspired me to work harder.
You'd be better if you were related to me. Hint, hint. I don't know who says that, though. I don't read anymore. I'm too busy killing and carving. I'm glad I'm the kind of guy who can create fun stuff for people. I feel like it's more a personality trait by this point than, like, an act of trying to do something specifically, like, to be a content creator. Some people absolutely do it for money, like, and money alone with, like, the fame that you get with it, but there's just a satisfaction knowing that you're making something that people can enjoy. And it's good as a creative outlet, too, with it. Because, like, if you can talk while you do stuff, then that's... It's good training for your brain. That's the best way I can put it. Because, like, yeah, anybody can be dead silent to completely concentrate on a video game and perform high-level actions with it, but... And it can be... some insanely impressive stuff that happens with him. But it's another step to actually hold a conversation, look away from something, and react to someone else while in that same situation. And people deserve kudos for that. Now let's see. Hey, let's go do hard and soft pressure. Work my way through the list until I see what this is. I've still gotta get used to strong arm stance. Apparently it's just fucking nuts as a skill, but I just can't bring myself to get the timing right on it. It's weird. I feel like it's something wrong with how I think it works with it, because it's supposed to be... because it's a two wirebug skill, but... most of the time I just use one for power sheaf. Alright, let's go fight monkey again. Have you ever fought a monkey? Yes, I have. Oh, he's a big one. Maybe shouldn't wear to quite write that. But damn, you're tall. Jesus. Face my fury. Come on, give me this wire bug. Get him, dog! Plant yourself on that sizable ass. It's all over for you. Oh, come on. You have all that hitbox and I still missed... I think this is the biggest Rajang I've ever seen. Like, in any game. Yeah, I know he's not done. He hasn't thrown me for a loop yet, literally. God damn it. Why was that so delayed? What the fuck? I can go against Risen level monsters, but Rajang just fucking throws me to the ground and punches me to death? Weird. Oh yeah, let's see if Monk Snail is here too. Hang on, Mr. Monkey Man. I got another important thing to do beyond turn your skull into a drinking mug. God, he tried to laser me out of the fucking wall there. Come on, Monk Snail. Please, please, please. There he is. Wow, he's actually there. Wow, actually wasn't expecting that. Okay, neat. Well, hey, even if I somehow lose this for some reason, putting that out into the universe, I'm at least not going home empty-handed. Small victories against large monkeys. There we go. And now he's running. I wonder what decides the voice lines of my character sometimes. He's running away! Keep attacking the open air! I'm sure everything will be just fine. There we go. Oh, come on. I hate that if it catches me mid-roar with power sheath, then it still cancels out the movement. It's very annoying. Oh, come on. Stop fucking roaring, you asshole. I'm the target. Me and me alone. Come on. Come on, Mizutsuha. Oh, motherfucking Remobra. God damn you. I was doing a thing, Remobra! You're gonna end up in a stir fry for this, Remobra. And not even a very good one. I'm talking 2.5-star walk buffet. Rightfully where you belong. That's right. Oh, that was a big balloon. Oh yeah, it takes a minute for you to recover when you're slippy slidey. I get so rarely get bubble blighted, I forget it exists. There we go. You know, it occurs to me, I don't think I ever actually beat Persona Golden. I beat regular Persona 4, but I don't... I think I just... Did I? Huh. Never really fought it before. Also, wow, I'm breaking you like a motherfucker. Mizutsuha, go! Fuck. I didn't mean actually go. Call it satirical exaggeration, dammit. I gotta figure out movement cancellation. It doesn't really matter for a vast majority of fights, but sometimes it really does fuck you. Oh, I hit blue sharpness. That's not good. That's right, break of your brain! I guess I'm killing Mizutsune first then. They both die all the same. I can't believe I fainted. I got a cart. That's not like me at all. But then someone was so super fucking delayed with that too. Like, I tried so hard to get out of there, and it just was not wirebugging away. Wirefuck off! Oh yeah, Intrepid Heart. Go, my heart! Kill that Gaju for daring to interfere with what shouldn't be his. Slip sliding away. Come on. On the bright side, coalescence. Come on, Mizzets. You're a fearsome four, yes, but the least of them. You're just horny. I wonder whatever happened to Gamif. She hasn't been in any game in like a while outside of stories. But they literally brought two... Actually, wait, no. Wait, no, Glavinus isn't in this game either. What the fuck? They brought Glavinus to World, that's fair, but then they just completely fucking left him out of this one. How about we get going soon? Weird. But then they also left Mizutsune out of World. I guess because you want to keep like the faster gameplay style, but I don't know, that still feels weird. Because like they're introduced as a whole, they're a whole four quartet thing going on. Like they're all found in different areas, but they all have like a life cycle rock, paper, scissors deal to them. And that was super cool. You don't really see that with a lot of monsters outside of like the Elder Dragons in now, but that didn't used to be a thing. It just used to be, oh yeah, these guys are fucking unique existences that are fucking wild and we have no idea why they're like this. Or what allows them to do the do they do. People try to say Mountain Dew is a white trash soda, but like, I fucking love it. It's great. It's got three different flavors of red. Which might be part of why they think. When I say it aloud like that. Still though. Uh-oh. Oh! You somehow missed. This guy feels smaller. Oh, come on. Oh, I did see a shock trap. Stop knocking me down, you asshole. Come on. Stop punching wildly in my direction. If I get hit, it's my own fault, I know. But what else is new?
Thanks for the support.
Oh, come on. I feel like you're somehow harder than the higher level version quest I just killed you in. Yeah, yes. Play that damn Pillar Man music. Stop just slightly exiting my attack range. That I am okay with. Less so when you just decide to have ups for days. Come on. Alright, yeah, you don't grab the whole rock, you just do a little, upswing of rock. I'm sorry, I've been fighting Raging Rajangs for a while. And somehow you are hitting me more consistently than them. Granted, I'm using a different weapon now, but come on. I went for a good portion of Iceborne fighting you with these. Jesus. Seriously, I swear to God, you're comboing me more than some of the actual Elder Dragons I've placed in this game. Which, I mean, fair enough, your whole deal is that you kill them if you, when you get angry enough, but come on. When did I stat switch? Weird. Oh good, he's picking a fight with Somni. I can use that to my advantage. By which I mean a murder implement. Hey, how's it do? Mine. There we go. Delicious. Hey, you ever heard of a seafood diet? Sees food, he eat it. It's an old joke, but a goodie. Just like, what do you get when you cross Rajang with a Somnicamp? Death! Less of a goodie, but hey, if you can't make a dark humor joke in this world, then where the hell can you? That's right. What? How did that break your horn? Are you serious? Oh yeah, I forgot I have an upward combo as well, too, with this. That's actually very useful.
Thanks for the support.
Keep chipping a Dippendale. Welcome to Chippendales! Oh wow, you landed right fucking there. And he tries to bounce on you like fucking Sonic, too, at the end. Oh, goddammit, my upswing. Part of me wants to capture you, but I also don't super care. There we go, that's the earth shit. That's the Rajang shattering kaboom I wanted. Yay! Still don't know why I wasn't able to wirefall out of there, but whatever. Things happen sometimes beyond our control and means. The secret to them in games and in life is to just accept them and learn. Hope they don't happen again, and if they do, then learn how to roll with them properly. Ah, straight from the monkey's ass. A fine cut of a claw and pelt. His ass is now mine, hanging from the mantle like that one SpongeBob episode. Boy, I mentioned SpongeBob a lot today. Eh, good show, until it wasn't. It's a shame how that happens sometimes with shows, where it's like, sometimes things just go so wildly off the wall in, like, a bad way.
I still have a long way to go to Katinoa.
Well done.
Like, current Simpsons is just a train wreck. Sometimes you'll get a good line, but, like, they're so, so rare. Yay, Master Rank 140. Let's see what my reward is. Another thing to kill, you say? Oh, boy! Talk to Chie. Another risen is arisen. We've added to your list of things to murder. Okay, let's see what you got here. Ooh, Risen Teostra. Oh, I'm curious about this one. But I am not using greatsword with this. No, no, no. Fuck that. Wait, am I weak to fire with this? Yes. -4. Okay, I'm gonna try with this for a second. Because theoretically, it's more damage per rate, and if I just don't get hit, then I just won't die.
That'll do.
Continue your research and increase your master rank. Ooh, afflicted Ragnikadaki. I can do those later, too. There's decent chance I won't lose, but I promise nothing. I have still yet to even use a single deodorant once in this game. Because they're good for blast and they're good for fart. I did not pick up the bird. The one important bird. I think I'm going to start off with a mount, and then I'm going to go for... I almost said go for Mary. Then I'm going to go for Diablos. Oh! Oh, wow, you are just, like, super fucking matted lion. You actually don't seem as affected by this. Like, yeah, sure, you got some little bits on your hind claws and whatnot, but... I feel like I'm fighting Foxy Grandpa Teostra, because he's got a fucking white streak in his hair. This isn't a risen Teostra, this is just a Teostra that got fucking old. He got sun-bleached. He's very mobile and turny, though. Like, look, he's just pivoting on his fucking paws. Normal Teostra doesn't really do that. He kind of picks a direction and then fires. Pun completely intended. This also feels like I'm super lucky having 777 health. Sorry, defense. Actually, wait, more, now that, because I'm coalescenced. Okay, his blast effects definitely are bigger. As are his leaps. That's a lot of kaboomies, right in a row. Wowie zowie, that's a lot of kaboom! And it hits through him now. He's bursting himself a lot. Okay. So, I'm seeing differences here and there, but they aren't super... Thank you, Intrepid Heart. I keep... Oh! He got knocked against the wall, I guess.
This is going to hurt.
Neat.
Face my fury. Let's keep it up.
Chipping away at it, chipping away.
Do you know why I'm actually going to bother to use bombs on?
Put down a bomb.
I put down a bomb! I'll pick up you, and... Was there not another silk? There it is. I feel like bombs are like a cool idea, but the damage they do is just not really worth it. Especially for Master Rank monsters, where it's like, oh yeah, 240 damage? Okay, I do that in several seconds. I'm very curious to see what his Risen moveset is going to look like. Yeah, so far he's just been a big fucking bitch. Hey, Almia. Ah, nice and nearby, too. Why are you down in the pit? That's not where you usually hang out, I don't think. Oh, you son of a bitch. Get back here. You're not running from me. Wavies. Wait a minute. Wave a minute. And punchy. And punchy. And punchy. Perfect. Why are you hitting yourself? Why are you hitting yourself? Why am I hitting you to death? There you go. Get right up in that hitbox. Oh, he exploded. So he didn't do a fall down because he was going in Risen mode. Oh, fuck. I'm gonna get the fuck out of this corner. Okay, so that escalated very quickly, I feel like. He just did his normal fire breath, but it was like super fast and like twice as long in range. Oh, I broke something. I don't know what, but it's broken now.
Humans could learn from you.
He's still just... Oh, wait, he doesn't have his heat aura anymore. Where did that go? He's doing his melty beam. His McToasty. I've still yet to really see anything super new. That's just a longer range of that. Oh, he does a wind upward with that now. Oh, your paws are leaking like a poison gas or some shit. Or you know what? That's probably a flammable gas, the more I... Now that I say it aloud. Thank you for knocking him out of that. Jesus, you deal a lot of casual damage in, like, single blows. Like that. Okay, so this one I can understand why you two shot me, given I'm minus 14 to fire in this armor.
What an embarrassment!
Yeah, whatever. Let's try that again, though, because, like, you still weren't that bad. Like, Camellios was absolutely worse, because he had combo jugglers. You just deal damage. Like, so long as I don't get hit, that's just not a problem. But then that also applies to literally everything. Where are you going? In hindsight, I could have picked up more... which we got potions as well while I was there. Jesus Christ, that wasn't even fire. That was just you running at me like a madman. Oh, I broke your wings. You love just dashing at me, it seems like. But then I guess regular Teostra did too. Come on. You still love leap forward shit. And aggression lines. Okay. Olay, Tigre. Uh-oh. Okay, new moves. Here we come. Oh, I see. You thrust your head just slightly forward enough that I couldn't do anything. What the hell is that earth-shattering kaboom that you keep trying to do and keep getting knocked out of every time? Oh, it's just instant explosive line. That's what it is. I see. So now there's just no... Oh, I get it. That's it. That's your gimmick. You just... There's just no wind-up anymore for your powdered bullshit? Or you can just choose to make it no lineup? I mean, yeah, sure, that's dangerous, but, like... Are you kidding? That's so minimal a change. The look of you, though. Like, that's what's fascinating to me. I love your color palette swap. But that's about it. Yeah, because you set up a fucking dome of explosions. Before the last ones could dissipate. I didn't hear an earth-shattering kaboom, either. Oh, wait, is that maybe something? Do they not give the invincibility frames that they used to? No, yeah, that was just nigh instant. Are you a combo juggler now? Is it? I can't really tell. Uh-oh. What? I was right in the fucking epicenter of that and it did nothing. What the fuck? I don't even know what the hell happened there. What the shit? Oh hey, great minds think alike, you got Almadron. Okay. So, is that literally just it? You're a pill popper now? Sorry, you know, I gotta run. Don't waste your own ride on me, I gotta do it myself. I use them better. Did she actually dismount Almadron? Oh, goddammit. It sure was. Oh, yeah, because they're following right behind me. Let us dance this dance of death and pain. Haha, broke your stupid face. Master the desert my ass. Did that hurt you? Where did that 300 damage come from? Wait, can I preemptively pop them? Wow. Await thy final punishment, Teostra. You've been a bad kitty. He's got like a fucking pompadour now because I broke his crown. He's actually really cute. Because, like, I don't normally like cats, but I like this Teostra. He's got, like, a fucking mane thing going on. Now, see, that's just his most dangerous thing, his willingness to fucking throw himself at me. Whoa. Okay, so that's, so that's the hyper nuke. Ironically, that seems to be the easiest out of all of the variants. Because it's just the same rules of typical Teostra nuke. You get the fuck out of dodge, or apparently you get all up in that shit. Look at how useful a heat shield is, too, am I right? I don't have it, by the way. Oh, you got knocked out again, huh? wonder if you're near death. I can only assume so. Sharpen thy claws, Petticoat Junction. What did you just hit for 262?
Thanks for the support.
Oh, you must have run into one of my cat's bombs. Felvine! Yeah, like, literally his willingness to just charge at you. That's the only thing of real danger that I'm seeing here. The rest of this is just regular fucking Teostra with a perm. Get me out of there! I wonder if Risen monsters have just a... not higher part health, but just less breakable parts. Okay, that one was admittedly impressive. But unfortunately, Coalescence is fucking you up. Coalescent Dual Blades. Uh-oh. Okay. Give me my staminems back. Why did I not eat? Thank you. And kaboom. There goes the boom. And here comes your doom. It reignite all you like. See? Outside of that one time you literally just fucking charged at me, that was not that bad. You're damn right.
You were great too, Minoto. How about we celebrate with some dongo?
So what the hell kind of mantle will you give me then, huh? I'm very curious now. Interesting. That was the fun one, but he doesn't seem... he seems like... I don't know, at least the rest of them had... different gimmicks and attacks? His just seemed Teostra, but now they're faster and there's no wind-up. Because, like, the drop-down point powder clouds, he kinda does that already. I get what they were going for with it, but, like... the thing that sticks out to me the most is just his hairstyle, that's it. That's my takeaway. I wonder what the fuck the anomaly versions of those exist are like, though, because, like, damn, if that might be horrifying later on. Holy, they give a lot of eggs, too. Oh, silver eggs, never mind. I mean, still money, though. Still money for bank. Well, I killed it. Let's see what this is. Whoa, what the fuck? This goes hard. Look at those. Oh god, look at those cape physics. What the fuck? I love it. Powder mantle. And ballistics. Continuously attacking a large monster will cause powder to form around you. The color and effects of the powder change over time. Get sent flying in red powder and you'll receive explosive damage. Attack when in blue for an explosive finish. Okay, so reduces hit count. Okay. How does that account for things? Like, this... is this what dual bleeds run on? Oh, that's a lot of weakness exploit and critical eye. Then Teostra Blessing... Master's Touch. Oh wow, this seems almost tailor-made for Bo, actually. Because you just stand at a distance, you strike the shit out of your enemy with multi-hit tools, and then pepper them in. Wow. That's actually really cool. The helmet, though. Actually, I want the chest plate. Ooh la la. The rest of this is actually not you.
Ooh, I'm itching to get started.
I kind of just want all the stuff with the mantle stuff on them now. Because that just seems properly good. Build up boost.
I have been wanting to be a blacksmith
I'll add some more of these off screen too with it, but yeah.
Okay, good luck.
I think this is going to do it for me here as well too with it, because I have no idea when the hell I unlock it other things, but I guarantee there's more to this story than just straight them. I have been Understar Virgo. Thank you all so much for watching my stuff. If you like what I do here and what I say, leave a like, follow, subscribe. Any of it helps immensely. And I'll be back again tomorrow with Hogwarts Legacy. So, thank you all once again, and I hope you all have an amazing rest of your day, night, whenever you like to enjoy me.